Welcome back. In this lecture, we are going to see about how to convert the regular expressions into finite automata. So let us start with some basic examples. Here we have 13 examples. So coming to the first one, here it represents 5 in the sense it does not going to accept any strings. So the finite automata for this can be written like this. So we have an initial state, but we don't have any final state because it is not going to accept any strings. And coming to the second one, here is epsilon. So epsilon in the sense, without taking any input, we can reach the final state. So for this, the automata can be written like this. You have initial state and this is the final state itself. That means without taking any input, you can reach the final state. And coming to the third one, simply A. So here this finite automata, which is going to be generated for this regular expression, should accept only the string A itself. So for this, you can have 1A, right? So starting from initial state and from reaching starting from initial state to final state, the only string accepted should be A itself. So while writing down the finite automata, our goal is to reach the final state starts from the initial state. So in that way we are going to generate the finite automata. So here we can reach the final state with either A or B. The fourth regular expression, it says that we can have the string either A or B. So for this, in this kind of case, either or like that, you can have parallel paths to reach the final state. So here is the initial state and here is the final state. And to reach the final state, you can go either by this way or you can go either by this way. So like this, this regular expression can be expressed with this diagram. And coming to the fifth regular expression, here the expression is AB. AB in the sense, it indicates the concatenation. It indicates the concatenation. So for this kind, which says that you can reach the final state first by having A, and after that by having B, you can reach the final state. So we should have both A and B. But here we can have either A or B. That is the difference. Observe the difference carefully, particularly for these two regular expressions. So here also I am having a state, initial state, and again a state, and here I am having the next state. So to reach the final state, so this is my final state, and to reach the final state, first I need to have A and after that I need to have B. So this is the finite automata for this regular expression AB. And coming to the sixth one, A star, that means A closer will include epsilon or 1A or 2As, 3As, etc. So for this, since it includes epsilon, this should be, first we need to write, this should be there. Why? Because it includes epsilon in the sense its initial state should be the final state. So here I can write like this, Q0 is its initial state and it should be the final state. And it accepts any number of A's. So that's why I can take a self loop here. So this is the automata reflecting this regular expression A star. And coming to the seventh example, A plus. So this is the closure of A. And this is the positive closure of A. So what is meant by positive closure? We have seen in the initial lectures of the theory of computation. So positive closure in the sense, it is almost equal to the closure, but it shouldn't include epsilon. So here in this case, the minimal string is epsilon, whereas in this case, the minimal string is A itself. So this positive closure consisting of any number of A's, and it should have at least 1A. It shouldn't accept epsilon. So it should have at least 1A, and after that you can have any number of A's. So for this, the automata can be written as, so here we initially accept at least 1A. So 1A is accepted, and after that any number of A's can be accepted. Any number of A's can we have. So in this case, it shouldn't accept epsilon. Why? Because to reach the final state, we have at least 1A, and after that you have any number of A's. So this is the equivalent finite automata for this example 7. And coming to example 8. See here, what is meant by this A plus B? So here, coming back to the example 4, here A plus B is nothing but you can reach the final state either with A or with the B. So here also the same thing. You can reach the final state either with A or with the B. But that should be repeated in any manner. That should be repeated in any manner. Here the thing is, and it also accepts epsilon. Whenever the regular expression is accepting epsilon, you can write the initial state as the final state itself. So here is my initial state, and I can make it final state itself. And here I can get either A or B in any number of times. I can get either A or B any number of times, including epsilon. So I can take the self loop for A and B. I can take the self loop for A and B. So here I can get while iterating itself, I can take A, I can take B, whatever I want. So this is the equivalent finite automata for this regular expression. They can be repeated infinite number of times. Whereas here, I have at least one A or at least one B. That's why I have taken a transition like this. Instead of self loop, I have taken this. Why? Because at least one A I should have or at least one B I should have. Whereas here, I can have any number of A's, any number of B's, including epsilon. So that's where I can make initial state as the final state. So this is the equivalent finite automata for this example. I'm coming to example 9, A star, B star. So here also I'm getting A any number of times and B I can get any number of times. But here there is a restriction. We shouldn't write like this. Why? Because here there is a restriction. What is that restriction in the sense? A's should followed by B's. So first we need to have all A's. There is no rule that there is no restriction on number of A's. And after that, we should have all B's. So that restriction is there here. And it also accepts epsilon. So whenever it is going to accept epsilon, I can write like initial state. My initial state become the final state. And here I can write A. So here initially, I can get any number of A's. And after having the certain number of A's, I can have, if I want, I can have certain number of B's also. So I can make a transition to the next state Q1. And I am making, this is also final state, and I can have transition with the B. So shall I write A or B here? We shouldn't write. So if you write A or B here, which says that we should have at least one B or we should have at least one A like that. No need to write A or B. You can write epsilon here. That means that from the regular expression, we are going to generate some epsilon NF here. Right? So whatever may be finite automata, any kind of finite automata, we can generate from the regular expression. So if you observe here, from this regular expression A star, B star, if you want to consider only A's, you can keep repeating this Q naught, B in the same state Q naught. If at all you want B, a number of B's also, then you can make a transition, epsilon transition from state Q naught to Q1, and you can have number of B's here. Suppose you don't want A's, you only want number of B's, then you don't, no need to have iteration here. You can directly reach this Q1, and here you can have any number of B's. So this is the way you can write finite automata for these kinds of regular expressions. And coming to the 10th one, AB whole star. So here is also a clean closure. Here is also a clean closure, and it accepts epsilon. So whenever the string is whenever epsilon is accepted, we can make initial state as the final state as usual. So here this is my initial state, and I'm going to make this as final state because it accepts epsilon also. Okay, and after that I should have strings like this. I should have strings like A, B. If at all A comes, then definitely B should also come. So no single A or no single B is allowed. I should have a certain number of A, B's. So concatenation of AB is needed, and also it accepts epsilon. So that's why I have taken another state here, and with A it goes to Q1, and with B it goes to again Q0. So now what happened? So if you consider here, for accepting epsilon, no need to have these transitions. So directly with the initial state itself, it can accept epsilon. So for accepting the minimal string AB, it can traverse from Q0 to Q1 with A input, and after that from Q1 to Q0 with B input, then only it reaches the acceptance state. So because it is not final state here. So if you make this as final state, then a single A is going to be accepted, which shouldn't be done. So for this, what we are going to do is, we should have AB sequence we should have. That should be repeated in our string, right? So you should have, you can have one A here followed by B. And if you want to make another transition, again A, B. And again A, B you are having. Like this, this A, B sequence can be repeated infinite number of times. That's why here, this is A, B star. So this, the same A, B closure is reflected with this diagram. Okay. And coming to the next one, A star, B. So here you have many number of A's. Even epsilon is also there. you may have yes or you don't, you may not have yes, but after that, after finishing all yes, we should have B. That means you are going to reach the final state with the B. So it can accept any kind of strings which should start with A and should end with the B, and all A's, after having all A's, we are having only one B in that string. So the regular expression, the finite automata for this is, we have initial state. This initial state shouldn't be the final state, because epsilon is not the minimal string. Here the minimal string is B itself. So we should have at least one B. After having number of A's here, after having number of A's here, you should have at least one B to reach the final state. So this is the final state. So you can take any number of A's here, and after that you can reach the final state with the 1B. So this is the equivalent finite automata for this regular expression. And coming to the 12th one, here is the just reverse case. So here you have initially at least one A you have, not at least, initially one A you have, and after that you have any number of B's. So you can reach the final state with any number of B's or with no B also, because here B plus, not B plus, this is B star. So here I can have initial state, and with transition A I can reach this final state, because single A is also accepted here. It accepts a single A also. Single A is also a minimal string here. So from Q0 to Q1 I can have A, and after that I can have any number of B's. So now taking the number of B's is optional. So I can take B's or I can left with A only. Depends upon the requirement. So this is the equivalent finite automata for this problem. I'm considering the 13th one. A star, B, C star. So by mixing these two, 11 and by observing 11 and 12, we can easily get the finite automata for 13th example. So here initially we should have number of B's, as many A's as we can initially, and after that it should have one B, and after that it may have many number of C's, may not have C's. So closer, A closer is there, and B, individual B is there, and followed by C closer. So I should have minimum, here the minimum string is A. So this is the initial state and this is the final state. So here the minimum string I should have is B. So before B I can have many number of A's. So I can take closer of A here, and after C I can have many number of C's. After B I can have many number of C's. So here I can have C. So in this way we can generate the finite automata from the regular expression. So in the next class I'm going to consider some little complex examples on the same concept, so that you can able to get it easily. Thank you for watching the video.